my mom's gonna be so proud.
Oh, you said your mom's gonna be proud.
I hope so.
I hope so too, auntie.
Hi guys, my name is Livia and I would say I'm a dancer just dabbling into modeling. I'm also studying theater in London right now and I feel like that's really helped me broaden my horizons as an artist.
The concept for today, we wanted to go a complete opposite way from what we did last time together. So our first shoot that we did together was full pink.
Yeah.
Who thought of that? Did I think of that? I think it was your outfit.
Yeah, again. It's like the outfit and then you build off
that. Yeah, and so for today, I wanted to do something opposite of that. And yeah. Initially I was gonna be like, oh, let's do all black since we did all pink last time. The seed of an idea was there, I was talking to you, and then you were like, this is the outfits that I have.
Yeah.
And you did show me black outfits, but the moment I saw this and I was like, let's build upon this.
Okay.
The last thing, this location was actually a last minute decision. And this is a spot that I always wanted to try and visit.
It's really unique because of this area and a lot of people come here for really nice Instagram shots. So I'm going to attempt to get a couple of Divya here and play around. There's also like harsh lighting right now because it's the middle of the day, which is exactly what I wanted. So I think we're gonna be able to get a couple dynamic shots doing this.
The problem was that I didn't want this shoot to be just another Instagrammable shot.
Yeah.
You know? So that's why I was always really hesitant coming here.
Yeah.
But the minute I saw your fit, you showed me the bucket hat, you showed me the glasses, I saw the colors here. It really complemented your look, so I was like, we have to go here now.
You do this?
Yeah. So what would you say got you into modeling to begin with?
Actually, it was really my family that brought me into it because they would always say like, I think you should really utilize this like skill that you have and try to do as many things as you can, because I was really like unsure of what I wanted to do in the future.
Do you feel like you also had a knack for modeling, or did you feel like, oh, what does my family see? Like, I guess I'll explore that.
Yeah, I think like without their support, I wouldn't have like tried. I think because I would always dance and there would always be like videos of that, and I would look at myself and I would be like, maybe this could be taken like a step further into modeling.
So what would you say your first love for an art form is?
Definitely dance, because my mom's actually a Bollywood dance teacher.
Really?
Yeah, from a young age I would always be on stage and it would always be my mom like teaching us, so I was very comfortable in that like environment.
Do you feel like it set a foundation of art for
you? Yeah, for sure. Like, it was kind of a love-hate relationship, to be honest, because in the beginning it was just what I had to do because my mom was a teacher, my sister danced, I should dance. So at first it wasn't really like a love for it, it was just like I had to do it. But then as I grew older, I really like found confidence in what I was doing. Like, if I wasn't able to dance, or if I hadn't started out as a dancer, I don't think I would be like the person I am.
Really?
Yeah, because it really like heightened my like identity.
In what way?
Like, I did Bollywood dance and like I lived in India and I really enjoyed that. So I think that really like shaped like where I'm from. I'm proud of like being Indian.
So it kind of like helped you embrace your culture a little
bit more? For sure. And I think that gave me confidence as well.
My first love form is also dance as well. I think that's also why we're able to click a lot when we're shooting, because both of us come from a dance background that we are able to understand like different shapes, different forms. And also just, I think confidence is such a foundation of dance, because without it, there's no performance.
Exactly.
Right? That's really where my confidence grew. There's kind of this identity that you have on stage.
Yeah.
And when you're performing.
Yeah, like
and
a
then,
persona.
Yeah, a persona. Yeah. And I think for me, I always felt a little bit more, not necessarily timid, but a little bit more on the shy side
like
growing
reserved.
Up. Yeah, more reserved growing up. So then the moment I got to be in the studio or on stage, there's this environment that you're suddenly sucked into where you're allowed to be a different person.
Yeah.
You're allowed to come out of your shell. I know you're there for this kind of grand gesture moment of all the hours of practice you put into the art form, and then suddenly you get to present it to the audience. I think the more and more you experience that, the more confidence you grow within that persona that then trickles into my everyday life.
Yeah, exactly.
And there's this environment of people who appreciate the art form with
you. It's a sense of like community as well.
Yeah,
being surrounded by like-minded people like really helps you even push yourself, because there's others around you who are doing the same.
Exactly. You know? Do you feel like you've been able to grow within that community in theater that kind of reflects a little bit the same way as modeling and dancing? environments? Or are they like very different from each other?
Me as a person, I always bring that into my work because that's like what I bring forward to the table is my dance, is my movement. I really feel like I have a vision as an artist when creating anything. I like setting up like a picturesque or like formation, that things that work and I know that would work. Being like a dancer, I think that really helps in like every avenue of my uni work as well.
These right now.
Right? I can't believe it. I actually can't.
Like,
oh my.
Yeah.
Oh my god, though. Wish on a bad bitch.
Yeah,
yeah, alright, let's continue.
Okay,
let's continue.
Because it's my first time doing theater like 24/7, I found it hard this year to not resent my work. So instead of like resenting it and thinking of it as work, I want to create that boundary of having my own like art for myself rather than like a group thing.
Do you know
what I mean?
No, I know exactly what you mean because I feel like I take that mindset whenever I'm creating content as well because it's really easy to get wrapped into the opinions of other people.
Yeah, exactly.
And you can't really help it because that's a very natural thought process, you know? What will people think of this? How will this look like? What's the result of everything?
Yeah.
Instead of having that be the primary mindset, I try my best to bring an almost selfish in a good way kind
of
mindset.
Exactly, yeah, because you do it for yourself rather than like for others.
Yeah, and I understand that obviously with this day and age of social media and everything, that can kind of be a twisted concept because you do want things to be presentable. And it kind of comes back to that, the performing arts, like we were talking about earlier. You want to perform, you want it to be perfect in the way that you visualize it. But at the same time, when I create content, I do think of it as my own art form and something that is, in a way, personal to me that I get to share with other people and share the passion with other people too. You were talking about a vision earlier that you have when you're modeling. Is it like before you start, you have this set way of like, I want to look like this in the end, or is it kind of like, I want to bring this energy? Or
maybe vision is more like, you know, like sensory with the eyes, but I think it's more of an energy that I bring or like a feeling because at the end of the day, even if you have like a picture in your mind that you want to like capture, it's very hard to like bring it to the T.
What energy do you think that you want to bring every time you come on set?
I think back of when I'm like in the shower and I'm like, you know, putting on my favorite music and I'm looking at myself in the mirror and I get hype and I'm like, yes, who is that? You know, like I look at myself and I'm like, damn, you know, I'm like proud of what I am and what I do, but it's very personal because I don't share that with like many people, you know, I just do it in the comfort of my bathroom. But I think when I was shooting with you, especially today, I tried to like flip that and, you know, I'm so comfortable with you and I feel like that's the mindset that I want to be in because that's when I'm truly just like relaxed and like free and like down to do whatever, you know, and I think that's the energy that I always want to have when performing and modeling.
Yeah, I think it takes a certain level of trust to be able to bring that energy because when you come on set and you want to give off that vibe, I want to feed into that energy too, you know, and kind of bounce that back between each other. You're trusting me to feel that energy and then be like, oh, let's capture that moment and vice versa. I also have like that vision or the energy that I want to bring, you know, and then like you said, it's really difficult to bring that vision to a T.
Yeah.
But I think that's when it becomes a beautiful thing when you can collaborate with someone else because you might have a vision but then someone else has their own opinions or something and then you come together and see what both those ideas can look like in this tangible
together.
Way.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
I like how you mentioned that, like, you feeling yourself in the bathroom because earlier when we got the shots and I showed you the shots, you had the same reaction to the images as how you just described when you look it in the mirror.
Yeah. Oh my god, that's so true.
I'm sorry, who's that bitch?
That reaction is like more than fulfilling for me because that's my art being translated to you, you know? That like ping pong back and forth is something that's really special within the arts that I feel like is such a special medium of expression.
Exactly. And I think most people really underplay like modeling or photography, you know, they're just like, oh, it's just a photo and you just pose. But it's actually, it's so much more than just that.
Yeah.
Because it's also like showing your own each like identities and like artistic point of view.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel like creativity or art has impacted your life?
That's a really hard question actually because I feel like my whole life really revolves around like creativity and like art because if I didn't have that, I think I'd be lost. Do you know what I mean?
No, like, I know exactly.
Like,
I don't know what I would do without this. Art has literally been not only like an outlet for myself, but also like connects me to my family and like to my
culture.
Yeah, my culture, my heritage.
I always think like, once an artist, always an artist.
Yeah, like, you can't bring it, you can't take it away.
Once you are able to express yourself through an artistic medium, it's hard to shy away from it in a sense.
Because it's kind of addicting, you know? Like,
it really is.
The feeling is so pure, I think, that you just want more.
How enlightening.
Yeah. It's been like a really nice like conversation.
Every time we meet, and like, or like, not every time, because we
the second time.
Can you believe this is only the second time?
That's super weird to
like,
me.
Because I feel like we just have been able to click so well. Like every time, and I really think it's because of art.
It brings people together.
I also made another video with you too. Go check that out if you haven't seen that yet. That was the first shoot we ever did together, and it worked out so well as well.
Pink baby.
If you could leave one message about the love of art or creativity to someone who, I guess, who's always wanted to try their hand at it, what would you say?
It can be seen as a very intimidating first step forward, but I think once you start, once you get your head in it, everything will work out. And don't be too harsh on yourself. I know that's like really a hard thing to do. You know, what's the harm in trying? Really, what's the harm in trying?
One thing that I think is tends to get looked over a lot, but is so important, is to just trust the process.
Yeah. Oh my god. That took me back to like my theater course, because that's like our quote of like the whole year.
Really?
That's like the motto of our year. Just trust the process, because by the end of it, like if you don't get like what you wanted, you would have had built relationships, built like experiences, and then after the process, you would know what you don't want to do next time, you know? Everything is just, it keeps moving.
Okay, thank you.
Yay, that was good.
Scene.